Dimensioning tools in CorelDRAW are used to measure and display the dimensions of objects or distances within your design. They help convey precise size and spacing information, making them particularly useful for technical illustrations, layouts, blueprints, or any design requiring accurate measurements. The parallel dimension tool. This tool measures the distance between two nodes. To draw a parallel dimension line, click the parallel dimension tool in the toolbox. Click to place the starting point. Drag to the second node and release the mouse button. Drag out and click the mouse button again to place the dimension line. To draw a vertical or horizontal dimension line, click the horizontal or vertical dimension tool and repeat the click and drag steps. By default, dimension text is centered on the dimension line. To measure an angle in the toolbox, click the angular dimension tool. Click where you want the two lines that measure the angle to intersect, and drag to where you want the first line to end. Then click where you want the second line to end. Finally, click where you want the angle label to appear. To measure individual segments in the toolbox, click the segment dimension tool. Click the segment that you want to measure. Move the pointer to where you want to position the dimension line, and click where you want to place the dimension text. To measure the distance between the two most distant nodes in multiple segments, using the segment dimension tool, marquee select the segments. Drag to position the dimension line, and click where you want to place the dimension text. To measure successive segments automatically, click the Automatic Successive Dimensioning button on the property bar, and marquee select the segments that you want to measure. Drag to position the dimension line and click where you want to place the dimension text. By default, dimension text is dynamic. If you resize the object to which a dimension line is attached, the dimension text is updated automatically to display the new size. You can make the dimension text static, however, if necessary. To make dimension text static, click the Dynamic Dimensioning button. Most dimension line controls on the property bar become unavailable. To set the display of dimension units, select a dimension line. On the property bar, choose options from the following list boxes. Dimension Style lets you choose fractional, decimal, or standard dimension units. Dimension Precision lets you choose a level of precision for the measurements. Dimension Units lets you choose the unit of measurement. To hide the dimension units, click on the Display Units button. To specify the position of dimension units, click the Text Position button on the property bar and click a text position. Change the point size and font of dimension units, and select the dimension text by using the pick tool. On the property bar, choose a font style from the font list box, and type a value in the font size box. To specify a prefix or suffix for dimension text, type a prefix or suffix in the prefix or suffix box on the property bar. To hide or show a leading zero with a dimension value, click the Show Leading Zero button on the property bar. To set default properties for new dimension lines, click Tools, Options, Tools. In the left pane of the dialog box that appears, click one of the following. Angular Dimension, to set default properties for angular dimension lines. Dimension, to set default properties for all other dimension lines. Specify the dimension style precision and units, prefix, and suffix. To be able to use dimension lines with precision, you need to snap them to specific nodes and objects. For this reason, when using the dimensioning tools, snapping needs to be turned on. Note, dimension lines cannot be brought into focus mode, but you can bring dimension text into focus. You can customize the extension lines on which dimension lines rest. You can specify the distance between the extension lines and the object that is measured, and the length of the extension overhang. Extension overhang is the portion of the extension line that falls beyond the dimension arrows. Select a dimension line. On the property bar, click the Extension Lines Options button. To specify the distance between the extension lines and the object, enable the Distance from Object checkbox and type a value in the Distance box. To specify the length of the extension overhang, enable the Extension Overhang checkbox and type a value in the Distance box.